Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play FIFA Mobile FIFA World Cup on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install FIFA Mobile FIFA World Cup and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play FIFA Mobile FIFA World Cup. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, to start we need to open our favorite web browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to that URL I have highlighted in green. Now, you can see on the PC screen. You don't need to type it, because I added a clickable link in the video description and as well in the first main comment. We ended up at this point on our own site of Usitility, where we have an in-depth overview on how you can download and install FIFA Mobile FIFA World Cup on PC. We search lower a tad and then click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on that link, we get to the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to this game FIFA Mobile FIFA World Cup on our PC. It is now obvious that we access some pros of using that emulator. So we are on the way to start downloading the FIFA Mobile FIFA World Cup by simply clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green. We then click on that button. Of course, the download step takes no time at all. Voila, this is the download. It's an executable file. The following step is to run the executable file, so we need to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the laptop or device. We have said yes. I minimize the web browser to start to see the installation software better. The installation software is very simple. It is made up of a couple of options, install and setup path. I am going to describe what setup path actually does. We basically simply click on it. And so we realize that got here the path where in fact the emulator will be installed. If we would like to vary this directory we are required to click on the browse option, and therefore we opt for another directory and set up the emulator where we choose. I prefer to keep it where it is. I simply click back. And therefore I just click on install. Great. The install commences and it is going to proceed with the download of those MB which are visible on the computer screen. As you download it, it may be a bit more or less megabytes. The download rate will go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, determined by your type of access to the web and depending on the speed of the emulator servers. Immediately they're going very fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this time, the emulator has actually been started successfully. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar which will advance to the right and when it actually reaches the ending, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. Believe it or not, the emulator has been started, there for the first time. Before we continue on, as now you can see, it created a couple of icons here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon will be the only one we are concerned about. Every time we need to run FIFA Mobile FIFA World Cup on the PC, we twice mouse click on this specific app icon and therefore run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let me conduct the next phase, which is actually a must, and that is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As can be seen, the Google Play is presented. At this point we are required to sign in. Currently once we're on this page, we must do the next phase that is absolutely mandatory. So we mouse click on sign in. At present it announces checking info. It might once in a while get stuck in checking info and it doesn't proceed. In that case, you may attempt to connect to your account after a few hours and it will most likely be corrected. At present we can provide our email address and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email and its associated password. For example, you make use of the exact same email you are using currently in your YouTube account. So that I will type my details and I'll go back as soon as I have done it. Voila, info typed. Discover Google welcoming us and offering us the terms of service. We would agree to them all by clicking, I agree. Then, it allow us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it checked and it'll make a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you can utilize this feature if you want. We simply click on accept. The Google Play Store is started without need to open it manually and completely on its own. To install the game, we must browse the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking on this app icon designated green colored. At this point that we are discovering the desktop of that emulator for Android, we see that we have right here the install app button. We then click on the button. On this page we come with the Android game. Let's click here on the install option that I am just displaying now in green color. This action will launch the software setup. Presently it will download on your PC and set up the game app. It usually takes a bit of time or it may possibly be very quick. It again all depends on our own internet connection. This has just completed setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this specific option that I am highlighting in green, to be able to start FIFA Mobile FIFA World Cup for the first time. I am currently on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're going to click on that fresh FIFA Mobile FIFA World Cup app icon which was created. That game app is started for the very first time. There we have it, I'm able to mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the sound level of that emulator. It is here, we have got the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume, this way we don't depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of your emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the greatest, we will turn on the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. This one is simply the very first one, we then click on this icon that I am basically mentioning in green color. Thus the display screen is maximized, experiencing one border at the top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. If ever we choose to play the application in full screen, we click this particular application icon. And we might presently be experiencing and enjoying the game in full screen setting. To escape the 100% screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we'd currently play in normal screen mode. At this point, I am on the way to explain you the computer keys mapping which is extremely useful. This step we will be ready to make use of the game application more effortlessly. The first task is to press this application icon. And right now there you will have the ability to complete the recommended configurations. I am going to keep the normal configuration, though if you want to improve that, you may very well do it without having problem. As you can observe, the emulator is fully in our own language. On occasion it happens that the emulator is started in the improper language, as an example, in Mandarin. And so to set it up in the appropriate language we go there to the cogwheel. So right here throughout many other settings, we click on the language drop down. We may go for the language we like, German, Chinese, and so forth. When the language is determined, we would save, the emulator will restart, and also the Android game, next time we use it, will of course be in the chosen language. Right now, you can find another thing that we have to take into account, and it is that we will receive an email indicating that a different device has been connected with our own Google account. It will definitely ask us if we're the ones who have associated with that electronic device. Absolutely, we really should not be troubled, simply because the emulator is emulating an Android device. And in order to determine which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we come here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. Be sure you browse here to the model selection. And now we see that the emulator is emulating a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for our video user demo. I hope you liked it, particularly that everyone found it interesting. If so, bring it a nice thumb up, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer all your comments, issues or ideas, let them in the comment area down below. You could even comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams from time to time, you have it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click any of those video tutorials that are appearing on the screen and see you in the next instructional videos. Bye.